Hi everyone. Today is 3rd of October 2018. This is 16th video about template metaprogramming. In this session, we will learn reference collapsing rule in C++ and function instance type, reference and pointer. And also we will learn function without function body. To follow this video, you probably have to watch my previous video about template metaprogramming, 12th episode, how to convert C++ type name to string. Also, type template metaprogramming 14, how to tell L value, R value, PR value, X value, GL value. Please watch these two videos. And also you need to download from this video, download the source code from our previous sessions. Before I start this session, I would like to ask you a few questions. These questions are very important for this session. What are the most fundamental two numbers in modern computer? The answer is 0 and 1, because these are binary digits. The next question is, what is the most fundamental data type in modern computers? They are integers. One number is at the origin on the number line. That is 0. Another question, what's the result of 0 times 0? The answer is 0. 0 times 1, 0. 1 times 0, 0. 1 times 1, 1. Substitute L value reference for 0, R value reference for 1. Then we substitute like this. 0 is all L value reference, and 1 is R value reference, like this. In this table, now remove 0 and 1. This is reference collapsing. It's very simple, isn't it? This is reference collapsing rule. Please try to remember this rule. Please also note that in C++, also in C, void pointer, there is void pointer, but there is no void reference. We will also learn about how to implement add L value reference T, add R value reference T. How to implement these two type functions we will learn. Also, we will learn DECL bar, how to implement this function. This function does not have function body. We downloaded this file by clicking this link and open show in folder and unzip it. Then in the folder, you can find this file talkplayfun type name.h in Visual Studio source code. This is the file I just shown. If you haven't downloaded it, please download it. In this file, we will include talkplayfun type name.h. Okay, we include. We will test reference collapsing rule first. As I explained here, I will copy this part for your reference here, paste. Like this. We will test reference collapsing rule first using type int. Using L value, it should be L value reference. Using R value, int R value reference. We will test this type std cout int like this. Talk play fun get type name type std. And then I will copy it several times. We will change this like this. And here, int r, it should be l value, int r, like this, l value reference, l value, and here, r value. I will copy once again. Like this. And I missed. See, about this type function, please refer to this video. We learned how to implement this type function macro, type name macro, in our previous session, template metaprogramming 12. We learned how to convert type name to string. Now we will build this function, this program. Okay, out. Please note that this works properly This is the way we expected in our type collapsing rule. We can compare with this one. Type is this int reference, int l value reference, then it will be like this. And int r value reference will be like this. Int r value reference, then r value reference. Then l value reference, l value reference, l value reference reference. Then this will be l value reference. And l value reference, r value reference, l value reference, r value reference becomes l value reference. When here r value reference and r value reference, then r value reference. So this reference collapsing rule holds like this. Please note that reference collapsing rule does not apply to typecast. Reference collapsing rule does not apply to typecast. Now let's try it. Int i 1, int l i, int r value reference r 5. Suppose we initialize i l r like this, then we try std cout std and l. I'll put some preprocessor macro if defined msc var. This is for Microsoft, in case of Microsoft. Else this is for Microsoft compiler, std cout. We are trying to cast, this is cast to I, and the result would be, let's fill it out. We expect, since this is int, simply int, we expect it should be, its type should be int, something like this. This is what we expect. Now let's see the result. Then talk play fun get type category. Here we cast static cast int reference. This is int reference. Then we cast I std and there. This is what we expect. Now copy this line of code. Here we will cast like this. Int like this. Int rr. Int. This is int. L we will cast like this. L. Int reference L. It'll be int reference int L. I will do like this. This is what we expect, the operation. This is L. Now I copy this part. We will cast to R here. R's type. This is R's type. R's type. R. Let's see. Int. Reference. Now build. We are using Microsoft compiler. Now we run, we compiled using Microsoft compiler. Let's try it. We are typecasting I to reference. The result is integer reference. Okay. We typecast I. This is int is typecast to R reference. The R reference is returned. It is up to this point, it is returned. Now, this is L. We cast L reference L value reference to L value reference, then the result is L value reference. But at this point, better be careful. We cast L is L value reference. We cast L value reference to R value reference. Then the result is R value reference. And also, if we cast R, this is R value reference. This is R value reference. This is L value reference. If we cast R value reference to L value reference, then the result is R value reference. And in this case, if we cast R value reference, this is R value reference, R is R value reference to R value reference, then the result is R value reference. Okay. Now I will copy the same code once again. This part is for Microsoft compiler. This is for GNU compiler, or I will put more message here. Microsoft C++. And I copy this part here. Either C++ or Clang. The result is a little bit different. Now, here again. Now, filled with GNU compiler. This is GNU compiler. Now, run. This is for either C++ or Clang compiler. See, the result is, this is the cast result. The result is always the cast. INT is cast to INT reference, then INT reference. INT is cast to INT R reference, then result is R reference. Please compare this part, and this part. This part is different. In case of C++ compiler, if L value reference, this is L value reference, is cast to R value reference, the result is R value reference. If we cast R value reference to L value reference, then the result is L value reference. And if we cast R value reference to R value reference, the result is R value reference. So either C++ or Clang, if we try with Clang, the result is the same. I would say Clang, here I will name C.exe. If we run it, the result is the same as C++. Okay, the result is the same. But if we use Microsoft compiler, I would say M.exe, then the result is different. In case of Microsoft compiler, if we cast L value reference to R value reference, then the result is R value. If we cast R value reference to L value reference, the result is R value. If we cast R value reference to R value reference, the result is R value reference. So we have to be extremely careful at these two. Okay. So in case of Microsoft compiler, in case of Microsoft C++, if we cast INT with INT reference, I value reference, the result is INT I value reference. This is cast. I will put more like this, std static cast INT I value reference. The result type is INT reference. I am talking about this case. R is here. And also static cast INT R value reference to L, it becomes INT R value reference. You should be very careful. I will change the order. INT R value reference, INT R value reference. In case of GNU, G++ and Clang, it is INT reference static cast INT reference R, INT R value reference static cast INT R value reference L. You have to be very careful about this. In case of Microsoft, R value reference to L value reference, then the result is R value reference. If we cast L value reference to R value reference, then the result is R value reference. In case of Microsoft, in case of GNU, Clang, if we cast R value reference to L value reference, then the result is L value reference. If we cast L value reference to R value reference, the result is R value reference. You have to be extremely careful about this. I will change function main to void reference collapsing rule and typecast. I change the function name and make a main function here. I will disable it. Then at this point, we create a function int increase. int a return a plus 1. Like this. I create another function int decrease. int a return a minus 1. Okay. I created two functions. I defined two functions. Now here, I define an integer a, an integer n, initialized to 1, like this. Now let's compare with this one and this function and int. Here, n is an instance or object of type int. N's type, declared type, type is int. N's value type is int l value reference. Okay, n is an instance or object of type int, and n's declared type is int, n's value type is int. Okay, in case of increase, increase is an instance or function of int, int of type, type int, int. Decrease is an instance or function of type int, int. Increase and decrease are both instances or functions of type int, int. Understanding this concept is very important. If we want to find out the declared type of n, here n is this integral type, we use decl type n returns declared type of n. If we want to find out the declared type of function increase, decl type increase returns function type, the type of increase. It is int, int. Okay. Also, if we want to find out the declared type of a function decrease, decl type dec decrease returns the type of decrease. It is int, int. Okay, I will declare another variable here, double d, for example, and another one, int I, for example. Please note that both n and I are of the same type int. Both n and I are of type int. Both increase and decrease are of the type int, int. Another thing we to know is that we can get the string representation of a type using talk play fun get type name. This is macro. We have to provide type here. We can get the string representation of an instance or object type. We can get the string representation of an instance of object type using talk play fun get type category. Here we have to provide type instance or just instance. So here using I type decl type I, using n type decl type n, this takes an instance then returns type like int or intd. If we want to display std cout, the type of I is talk play fun get type name, type name, then we provide type like this. If we want to use instead of this is type name, this is type name, the type of n is talk play fun get type category. Here we provide an instance. In this case we provide type, in this case we provide category, then n instance. I hope you understand what it means. Now let's build and try. See out m, it is up m. So type of I is int, type of n is int. I hope you understand how to use these functions. We want to know increase type, then we can do the same thing. DACL type increase. Then we can print out the type of increase is talk play fun get type name. Then we provide increase type. This is type name. The same way std cout the type of decrease is talk play fun get type category. Then we provide an instance decrease. Please note that we implemented this function in our previous session. So please watch about these two macros in my previous video. Now let's run this. And so the type of increase is int int. The type of decrease is int int. I hope you understand what the function type is. So its type is this function's type is type of increase is int int. Increase is an instance or function of type int int. In the same manner, type of decrease is int int. Decreases is an instance or function of type int int. Now let's learn the concept of pointer. We can define pointer like this integral pointer int iptr. We can take address of I int, then reference ILEF. We can take reference like this. Then std cout the type of iptr. This is pointer. We can display like this. Talk play fun get type category. We provide instance iptr std cout. In the same manner, the type of iref talk play fun, we will use type name. I will say type name. In this case, we have to provide this decl type. This function takes type name, so it should be decl type iref std and there. Now let's run it. Type of iptr is integer pointer. Type of iref is L value reference, integer L value reference. In the same manner, we can take address of a function. Also, we can take the address of a reference. The reference of a function. We will take function address first. Then int. Int, this is type, function type. Then we take address increase ptr like this. Then here function increase. Then we take address. Please note that this is for address of operator is address of operator. Here is address of operator. Okay, and int int again decrease, and we provide a pointer variable here decrease decrease ptr. Here decrease is same to decrease. Okay, so we print out the type of increase and decrease ptr like this. Std cout the type of increase ptr. This is function pointer is talk play fun get type name and type category. Here we provide instance increase ptr. I will copy this part. The type of decrease ptr, decrease decrease ptr, is we will use type name like this. Please compare with this code and this code. We use type name, then we have to provide decl type like this. Okay, Now let's build. Okay, the type of increase PTR is function point is int. Int, this is point, it means pointer. And also the type of the decrease PTR is int, this is pointer. Now we take reference. If we want to take reference, then we can do like this. This is pointer, this is reference, ref, and we don't need address pointer here. And here this is reference, ref. Okay, in this case the type of ref ref, increase ref and decrease ref is reference. Here we can display std cout the type of increase ref or function reference is talk play fun get type category. Here we have to provide instance increase ref and then std cout the type of decrease ref or function reference is talk play fun get type name. Then we have to provide type, decl type, then decrease ref std and there. Now let's build. Okay, so if we examine it, here is the reference ref, reference mark, this is reference, this is type pointer, this is pointer. Okay, please understand this concept, then I will summarize it here again. The reference type of increase is int. Int here we have to provide reference symbol here, but if we do this it becomes function returning integer reference. So we, to prevent that, we have to provide parentheses here. Okay, so if we don't provide, if we don't provide parentheses, then it becomes a function type that returns integral L value integer reference. Okay, taking one integer, so we have to provide, we have to bind or enclose with parentheses like this. And the pointer type of increase is int, then we have to provide star like this, asterisk like this. In the same manner, the reference type of decrease is int here. We have to provide reference. The pointer type of decrease is int pointer int. Okay, please understand this concept. And there's another thing we need to know. In case of ordinary object such as int a, double d, a has type category and value category. D is an instance of double d. Type category and value category. About value category and type category, please refer to my previous video about this. So decl type a returns the declared type. Declared type. Declared type means type category. Type category of a DECL type. Please note that I am using two parentheses here. Double parentheses returns the declared, returns the value category of A. Okay? In case of function, in case of function, DECL type increase returns the declared type of function increase. So its value will be int. Okay, the same manner, declared DECL type decrease returns the declared type of the function decrease. It is int. But in case of function, DECL type increase, we have to provide integer here, int, integral type instance, for example a, then it returns the return value. It returns the type of the return value. Return value of increase. In such case, it is int, because function increase returns int, an instance of int, so its return type is int. In the same manner, DECL type decrease, for example, I, then I is integral type, it returns the type of the return value of decrease. In this case, it is int. So decrease, this is different. DECL type increase returns int, whereas DECL type increase, and we have to provide an instance of integer, for example integer like this, then it returns the type int. Okay, understanding this concept is very important. Now let's try it. Std cout the type of DECL type increase is talk play fun get type name here. We have to provide get type category. Type category increase, because increase is an instance of function, we have to provide instance here, or we can say type name. I will use type name. Then here DECL type, it returns type like this. Okay, we use this syntax here, please understand. Then std cout the type of DECL type here, we find once again, increase here. We have to provide this increases function argument, int, for example, like this, is talk play fun get type name DECL type here, increase here, we have to provide argument. Say it shows argument A, for example A, we can provide argument A like this, then std and there, or we can provide any instance type int like this, we can do like this. Okay, now let's build and run, then n. Please note that the type of decrease, this returns function instance, function type, decreases type, okay? It returns decreases type int int, but this cell type increase int, we provide an, we call this increase function, then return type is returned. Understanding this concept is really, really important. So instead of passing int integer type this way, we can also do like this. We can do the same here. Please note that we can, instead of this, we can provide a. Then I would say a. These are all the same. And another one is here, watch carefully. Instead of doing this, std, we are cheating. There is some way to cheat. For example, int. This is pointer. Okay, this is pointer. Then we can convert to reference. Say this pointer does not exist at in fact. Then we convert the. I will cast it here. Zero is null. This is cast. We are casting zero to integral address like this. Okay, I will make it simpler. Watch it carefully. Zero. We cast it to an integer pointer. This integer pointer, zero. Then we can make it value like this. Okay, it actually does not exist. Such value does not exist. So I copy it, then I paste it here like this. Okay, now let's run it. We are cheating the compiler. It is not A, it should be I or N. Here I, we will provide I. Okay, now let's build. Okay, it works exactly the same way. We provide integer is an integer value. Another way we commonly cheat the compiler is that we make C++ compiler believe that we are actually returning something. We can define functions like this, type name t, tr value reference, decl value. Please note that this is template function that returns reference, r value reference of t like this. We create a decl value function like this, but this function does not have function body, but it can be very useful. We cannot call it directly, but we can use in compile time expression. We cannot use this function at runtime, but we can use it at compile time. Now let's see how we use this function here. Instead of this, we have to provide an instance of integer here. Then we can do like this, decl value int. See, this function returns an instance of integer type. Then we can modify like this our code. Then I will change it like this. Let's see, 1, 2, 3. Okay, now let's build. Okay, M is built. Okay, it runs. This is the function we just defined, int. So this is a function that does not have function body. In C++ standard, instead of using this, C++ standard defines such function. It is called std var. Okay, in case of C++ standard, they define functions like this. Instead of doing this, this is custom made std decl var var int. We can do the same. We can just change this part. Standard library defines decl var this function. So let's build and run. Okay. So it's the same actually. Originally, I planned to implement add L value reference, add R value reference, and also explain how to implement decl var this function, how to use these. At the beginning of this session, I planned to implement these functions too, but I think this session becomes too long. About these things, add L value reference and decl var in next session. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you for watching.